वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शफीक अहमद एंड यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल लेट्स लर्न टुगेदर। या सो वेलकम बैक टू आवर क्लास एंड आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज व्हाट इज डेमोक्रेसी एंड व्हाई डेमोक्रेसी। दैट इज क्वाइट एसेंशियल ओवर हियर दिस चैप्टर बिकॉज़ दैट इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड दैट इज ऑफ द सिलेबस ऑफ सिविक्स आल्सो बिकॉज़ दिस वन इज क्वाइट इंपॉर्टेंट एज all the other chapters are quite related to this chapter, what is democracy and why democracy. Okay, that is presented by me, Shafiq Ahmed, over here. So you might have heard a lot of definition of democracy in your previous classes 6, 7, 8 and onwards, but let us define the word democracy and let's go deeper and deeper about its meaning, its features, merits and demerits. According to Abraham Lincoln, democracy is government of the people, government chosen by the people, that is of the people, and that is government by the people again, and government is controlled by the people and for the people, means is again the government is only for the people, means whatever the people will wish, the government will have to according to the wishes of the people or the citizens of the country. Because in a representative type of democracy, the citizens are not directly interfering in the affair of the government. The citizens, they used to elect their representative, and those representatives such as MLA and MP, they used to frame rules and laws for the country and they used to take decisions. But the thing is important, whatever is here, that the citizens, who would they select? They must take the decisions. And none of other people should take decisions on behalf of the citizen of the country. So that is more important over here, that whom we are selecting, they must have the power. They must have the power to take final decisions for the country, to frame rules and regulations for the country. They must have the power. That I mean to say over here. Okay, the word democracy comes from a Greek word, that is demokratia. In Greek, demos means what? People, and kratia means what? Rule. That is democracy here means rule by the people. So you can write it over here in your notebook also about this one, that the word democracy has come from the Greek word. And we are dividing the two words into two different parts, demos and the people. That is democracy means rule by the people. So is that definition is enough, that democracy is ruled by the people, or the definition that Abraham Lincoln has given us, that government of the people, by the people, for the people, is that okay? We are accepting this definition from long time, but we will have to look into it, whether it is really acceptable or there must be something added to this definition of democracy. Let us see. One of the boys, Siddharth, of your class, he has a different version of democracy because he has seen the government performing with his eyes, in his front he has seen all the activities of the government, and that's why he little bit changed the definition of democracy. And let us see and have fun, but we are not going to accept his definition. Democracy is of the people, he is writing. Of the people means that is away from the people, that is not for the people, he is writing. And he's writing that democracy is far, far from the people, means it is not connected with the people. The people are really far away from the people. And the last one, more funny, he wrote that democracy is where they used to buy people, buy, B-E-U-Y, not B-Y, B-U-Y, means there Siddharth might have seen that people are earning a lot of money for selling out their one precious vote. Vote is the most precious one in a democratic country. All the adult citizens of the country are having one precious vote, and that they should keep it very secretly and preserve it and use it very nicely. But here Siddharth is saying that he might have seen that people are selling out their votes for the cost of only money. So that's why he changed the definition, that democracy is of the people, far away from the people, and where the where the government used to buy the people. But we are not going to with Siddharth's definition. Siddharth has written this type of definition or different version of democracy only because he might have seen something wrong in a democratic country. Let us see. what happened next? He's saying, Siddharth is saying, why don't we accept that? My definition is asking that why don't we accept this definition of his definition? Siddharth is obviously wrong over here, but we will have to think of why such type of definition he has written. He might have seen something in his, with his own eyes that in democracy something is going wrong. So let us see, let us move ahead towards the next moment of the chapter, that is the common factor to all democracies. That is really very important for 1 mark question and answer for my dear students. Common factor to all democracies is what? That the government is chosen by the people. In democracy, we all know that the government is chosen by the people. So can we say that if the government is anywhere in any country is chosen by the people, then that particular country is a democratic country? Or there must be some more criteria also to check out whether a particular country is it really a democracy, or really they having a democracy, or is it enough if the people are selecting or electing the government, then it is democracy. We can't say, my dear students, just by this definition that in a democracy the government is chosen by the people, and if it is so, then we will say and we will conclude that particular country is having a democracy. We can't say. We will have to check. There must be some parameters. Let us see. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. The same thing are written over here in the next statement also, that democracy is a form of government where the rulers are elected by the people. Now, who are these rulers? The rulers over here are those persons who used to run the government, means make laws for the government, for make laws of the country for the citizens and implement it also, and as well as judiciary is also included among these rulers. So we can't say that the judiciary and the executive department are not in the scene. They are also in the scene. They are also one of the levels of the government. So let us see whether this type of people are there. If the rulers are there, if those rulers are elected by the people, then can we say that democracy, that particular country is a democracy? Let us see. We will have to check out. So how can we check out? There are some features of democracy, and that will help us to check out and find out whether a particular country is a democratic country or not. My dear students, the first feature of democracy is what? We will have to check whether a particular country is really having a democracy or not. And the first feature is, what is the first feature saying? In a democracy, the final decision making power must rest with those elected by the people. Means the people whom we are electing, whom we are electing, they must have the final decision. They must have the power of final decision, to take final decision. We will check one country, that Pakistan, we will check whether they are having this particular feature of democracy, whether they are violating this one. And we will check with our country also, India also, whether our country is really violating this particular feature of democracy, or it is with this feature of democracy. We will think of it. I will ask you all. Let us first start with Pakistan. Let us check whether this particular feature of democracy is dealt in Pakistan or not. General Pervez Musharraf of Pakistan, he was leading a military corps, means he was the head of the military in October 1999. What he has done, he overthrew the democratically elected government, means the government which was elected by the people. He forcibly overthrew that government, and he declared himself as the chief executive of the country on 12th October 1999. Means he declared himself that I am the chief executive of the country. All the decisions will rest with me. I will take the final decisions of the country. He overthrew that democratically elected government, the government which was elected by the people. As because he was having power, he was the head of the military department, so he was saying that, and he did it. Later on, his designation, he changed to president in 2002. He held a referendum. Later on, he changed his designation to president. And in 2002, he held a referendum. Now, what is that? A referendum is a general vote by the electorate. Now there is one more new word, my students, electorate over here. So electorate are those people who are eligible to vote in election. So election mein jo log vote kar sakte hain, unko hum log electorate kehte hain. So in 2002, General Pervez Musharraf, held a referendum that he asked the people to vote for choosing the president of the country in the country. And in that particular voting system in 2002, he won flexibly. That is 90% of the vote he got in the country, and that particular win gave him 5-year extension. 5 saal ka aur unko extension mil jata hai General Parvez Musharraf ko ye referendum karne se. You can find more about this particular referendum in the link that I have given. You can see it over here. I will share it with you all after the class. So according to the Pakistani media, not Indian media, not other media, according to Pakistani media, even Human Rights Commission and democracy activists, the people who are involved in democracy, these people are saying that General Parvez Musharraf has cheated, has used malpractices and has done fraud. According to Pakistani media, Human Rights Organization and democracy, they are saying that General Parvez Musharraf has cheated the people, has forced the people to vote for him. And let me tell you, he got 90% of the vote. Let us see about the next step of General Parvez Musharraf, what he did next to stay in the country for a long time. In August 2002, he issued a legal framework order. Now, what is that? He issued legal framework order, one order that legally. And according to this particular legal order, he was having the chance, he was having the power to amend the constitution of Pakistan, to change the constitution of Pakistan. And he changed the constitution of Pakistan, in which what was declared in the new constitution, that the president can dismiss the national as well as provincial assemblies. President, he was elected as the president for the next 5 years. Now he is increasing his power. According to the new constitution, he can, means president means he, and he can dismiss the national as well as provincial assemblies. National level mein jo assemblies hai, yani parties hai, wo usko kya kar sakte hai? Dismiss kar sakte hai. Different parties ko, yani opposition ko wo dismiss kar sakte hai. Even he can dismiss provincial means regional or state wise jo parties hote hai, usko bhi wo dismiss kar sakte hai. According to this particular legal framework order issued by the President General Parvez Musharraf. Uske hisab se ye kisi ko bhi dismiss kar sakte hain, kisi bhi party ko, national ho ya provincial means regional, hai na, area wise. To ya to provincial assemblies ho ya national assemblies, he can dismiss. Now let us see next, the work of the civilian cabinet. Now what is this new term over here, civilian cabinet? Let me share one screen with you about the civilian cabinet. Let me share it. Come on, civilian cabinet. Oh, I think I will have to open it first. This civilian cabinet, the common populace who are not in any way involved in the running of the government. It means what? The people who are not the people who are not in military. They are known as the civilian. We the people are not in the military. We are not involved in the military. Then we are known as a civilian. So this is the cabinet or the committee that has been organized by the people. But what are the function of these people? They used to look into the legal or the common affairs of that particular area. Now, according to this particular Parvez Musharraf, General Parvez Musharraf, what he did really there, you can see in the next screen I will share. Yeah, this one. From here. Okay. So, it was that civilian cabinet that the people who are not in the military, they are not involved in military, they are not in the army, they are known as a civilian. So, that cabinet is used to look into the affairs of the government in the regional wise, you know, state wise, yeah, local people will take care. But that civilian was also supervised by the National Security Council. Ab ye civilian cabinet ko kaun supervise karenge? National Security Council. And that is all according to the new legal framework order. Ye legal framework order jo unhone release kiya tha, usi ke hisab se ye tha ki ye civilian cabinet ko bhi, yani ki aam logo ka jo ek committee hai, उसको कौन सुपरवाइज करेंगे? नेशनल सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल। और ये नेशनल सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल में जो मेंबर्स थे वो सारे मेंबर्स कौन लोग थे? मिलिट्री ऑफिसर्स, यानी कि पूरे मिलिट्री ऑफिसर्स से ये भरा हुआ था नेशनल सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल। एंड दिस मिलिट्री ऑफिसर्स वर डायरेक्टली और यू कैन से इनडायरेक्टली दे वर कंट्रोलिंग दिस सिविलियन कैबिनेट ऑफ द पीपल ऑल्सो। सो आफ्टर पार्टी पासिंग दिस लॉ, लीगल फ्रेमवर्क ऑर्डर, after passing this law, there was two things in the country that president can dismiss national as well as provincial assemblies, and the president can, or you can say the military officers are assuring or supervising the civilian cabinet as well. Now, after passing the law, elections were held. क्योंकि अब यो जो है प्रेसिडेंट जो है काफी सिक्योर फील कर रहे थे, वाज फीलिंग वेरी सिक्योर कि अब जो है हम काफी सिक्योर हैं, अब हम इलेक्शंस करवा सकते हैं। सो ही स्टार्टेड, ही हेल्ड इलेक्शंस इन द नेशनल एज वेल एज द प्रोविंशियल असेंबलीज, है ना, नेशनल और प्रोविंशियल असेंबलीज में दोनों तरफ उन्होंने इलेक्शन करवाया। और लोगों को पता था नेशनल लेवल में भी और प्रोविंशियल लेवल में भी कि प्रेसिडेंट जो है हमारे पार्टी को डिसमिस कर सकता है कभी भी, बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस लीगल फ्रेमवर्क ऑर्डर। तो एक तरीके का उन्होंने प्रेशर बना दिया था, जनरल परवेज मुशर्रफ जो है एक तरीके से उन्होंने प्रेशर पहले ही से बना दिया है पार्टीज के ऊपर में कि कोई उनके खिलाफ वोट ना कर सके। सो ऑन 6 अक्टूबर 2007 प्रेसिडेंट इलेक्शन, प्रेसिडेंशियल इलेक्शन वर हेल्ड with Musharraf winning 98% votes in the Senate, Parliament as well as the four provincial assemblies. यानी अलग-अलग चार जगह से भी उन्होंने जीता और 98% vote उन्होंने Senate, Parliament और चारों assemblies से जीत लिया था। So now he was having the opportunity to become what? To become the president of the country for the next 5 years. Let us see, चार जगह से तो उन्होंने जीता है, लेकिन और भी कई जगहों से दूसरे लोग जो हैं वो elect हुए, जीत गए थे। Though the elected representatives had some powers, they were also having some power. जो अलग-अलग जगह से दूसरे लोग जो जीत गए थे, they were also having some power. But the final power rested with military officers and General Musharraf himself. लेकिन final जो power था वो किसके हाथों में था? Decision लेने का, according to this particular constitution and according to the 98% votes, as you can see, Musharraf has won 98% of the votes. So the final power rested with that military officers and General Musharraf himself. So na to ye military officers elected the, they were not, they have not won the election, na these military officers, neither General Parvez Musharraf. Aur lekin fir bhi ye final decision kiske haathon mein raha? General Parvez Musharraf ke aur unke आर्मी ऑफिसर्स के हाथों में रहा। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस सिचुएशन, अब हम लोग चेक करते हैं वो फर्स्ट फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी जो ये कहता है दैट द फाइनल डिसीजन मेकिंग पावर शुड लाई विद द पीपल हु इज इलेक्टेड बाय द सिटीजन ऑफ द कंट्री। तो इस केस में हम लोग देखेंगे पाकिस्तान के केस में दैट ये पहला फीचर जो डेमोक्रेसी का वो वायलेट हो रहा है, दैट परवेज मुशर्रफ इज हैविंग द होल पावर, ऑल द पावर ही इज हैविंग, बट ही वॉज नॉट इलेक्टेड। So let us see, can we still call Pakistan a democracy? Obviously no, because of many, many reasons. Let us see what are those reasons. You can see that people have elected the representative to the national as well as provincial assemblies. Ana, log jo hai, elect kiya unhone representative ko apne national or provincial level mein, dono level mein. But those elected representatives were not really the rulers because they were not taking the final decisions. General Parvez Musharraf and the army officers who were not elected by the people, they were taking the decision, final decision. That's why we can't say that the elected representatives were really not the rulers of Pakistan at that time, during the time of General Parvez Musharraf. So they are violating the first feature of democracy. They cannot take the final decisions. These elected representatives who were elected by the people, but they have to understand, they have to follow all the rules and regulations, you know, framed by General Parvez Musharraf. So the power to take final decision rested with army officials as well as General Parvez Musharraf, and none of them were elected by the people. Na to yahan par General Musharraf jo election mein khade the aur nahi to unke army officials, lekin fir bhi power kiske haathon mein hai? Unhi ke haathon mein. Kyun? Kyunki wo president bane hue the aur president ke paas mein kya tha ki wo kisi ko bhi dismiss kar sakte hain, kisi bhi parties ko. So final decision jo hai unhi ke haath mein tha. So not only in Pakistan, aisa aur bhi bahut sare डिक्टेटरशिप कंट्रीज में या मोनार्की बेस्ड कंट्रीज में होते हैं। दिस हैपेंस इन मेनी डिक्टेटरशिप एंड मोनार्कीज। दे फॉर्मली हैव एन इलेक्टेड पार्लियामेंट एंड गवर्नमेंट. ये बहुत सारे कंट्रीज जो डिक्टेटरशिप जहां पर अभी भी है, मोनार्कीज जो है, तो वो लोग अभी भी क्या करते हैं, पार्लियामेंट में इलेक्शन करवाते हैं, गवर्नमेंट होता है, इलेक्टेड होता है, लेकिन रियल पावर फिर भी किसके हाथ में रहता है, जो लोग इलेक्टेड नहीं होते हैं. सो वी विल हैव टू चेक दिस वन इन आवर कंट्री ऑल्सो, इन अदर कंट्रीज ऑल्सो. पाकिस्तान में हमने देखा कि जनरल परवेज मुशर्रफ एंड हिज आर्मी ऑफिसर्स वर नॉट इलेक्टेड इवन दो दे वर हैविंग द फाइनल डिसीजन मेकिंग पावर. सो द रियल पावर मस्ट लाई विद द पीपल, विद द पर्सन हु इज इलेक्टेड बाय द सिटीजन ऑफ द कंट्री. एंड इफ इट इज नॉट सो देन इट इज अ वायलेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. इन फ्यू कंट्रीज द रियल पावर was with some external powers and not with locally elected representatives. Now you can see over here that the real power are with some external powers, means the country is being ruled by the elected members of the assembly, you know, those who are elected, they are ruling the country, but they are following the orders of other external powers such as America or other countries. We can't take name, you know, otherwise they will claim, you know, that please catch Shafiq Ahmed. And he is claiming that Pakistan, America is representing or colonizing some countries. So we can't take any name, but some external powers are controlling other countries indirectly. So the real power again are in the hand of the external powers. So in that case also, we can't say that it is a democratic country. This cannot be called people's rule. Democracy means what? People's rule. वहाँ पर किसका rule होना चाहिए? People का, citizens का होना चाहिए. So, ये कहानी जो हम लोगों ने अभी पढ़ा है, that about Pakistan and other dictatorship countries, this particular story about Pakistan and other countries about dictatorship and monarchies, give us the first feature of democracy, that in a democracy, the final decision-making power must rest with those who are elected by the people only. Hope you understand this particular first feature of democracy. Hope that you have liked the video. And we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care. A very good morning to all of you, my dear friends. This is Shafiq Ahmed, and you are all welcome to your favorite YouTube channel, Let's Learn Together. Welcome back to all of you, my dear students. Today we are going to study about the second feature of democracies, and that is one of the heading that you can see below that feature of democracy, what is written there, free and fair electoral competition. That is means if there is an election in the country, in a democratic country, then it should be how? It should be free and fair electoral competition. There should be fair everything. And what is the second feature of our democracy? What is it saying? A democracy must be based on a free and fair election. Free means no one should be charged for voting. You know, it should be free and everyone should be allowed to vote, the adult citizens of the country. So a democracy must be based on free and fair election should be there. There should be nothing, there should not be any type of cheating in the electoral competition or while voting. There should not be any type of cheating in a democracy. So a democracy must be based on a free and fair election where those currently in power, that is the second line that I'm going to read, that is quite important, my dear students, where those currently in power have a fair chance of losing, means those who are in the power right and currently in the country, such as in India, BJP government is in power right now, and in China we will go through. So whoever is in the power at the current time during election, they must also have a fair chance of what? Winning, not winning, of losing. They must also have a fair chance. Unke paas bhi ye chance hona chahiye ki wo bhi haar sakte hain, hai na? Agar aisa nahi hai, अगर वो करेंटली जो पार्टी है वो पूरे पावर का इस्तेमाल कर रहा है कि वो हार नहीं जाए, वो जीत जाए, तो ये फिर डेमोक्रेसी के सेकंड फीचर को वायलेट करेगा, है ना, ब्रेक करेगा. तो इसके लिए हम लोगों को बचना है, और हम लोग दो कंट्री को चेक करने वाले. वी आर गोइंग टू चेक टू कंट्रीज, वेदर दे आर running or doing free and fair electoral competition or not, whether they really fit according to this particular second feature of democracy or not. I will ask you after discussing about our Chinese bhai, hai na, that is Chini bhai log ke baare mein padhenge. और उसके बाद एक कंट्री मेक्सिको के बारे में पढ़ेंगे एंड आफ्टरवर्ड दैट आई विल आस्क यू वेदर दे वायलेट दिस सेकंड फीचर और वेदर दे आर डूइंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द सेकंड फीचर इफ दे आर रूलिंग इफ दे आर परफॉर्मिंग देयर ड्यूटीज अकॉर्डिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी देन वी वुड बी एबल टू से दैट रियली दे आर हैविंग अ डेमोक्रेसी इन देयर कंट्री बट टू बी अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री the country must follow or must fit according to the all features of democracy not only one feature okay let us see and study about chinese bhai that is about the chinese people wahan kya hota hai kaise hota hai let us see about in china elections are regularly held after 5 years like in india in china also they are having elections in every 5 years and they used to elect 3000 members they used to elect 3000 members of the country's parliament yani parliament mein 3000 members ko wahan ke log elect karte hain aur wahan ke parliament ka naam kya rakha gaya hai dekhenge chinese name kya hai quango renmin daibyo and dahui this is quite hard for us to remember so we will remember this national people's congress isse hum log yaad rakhenge that is the name of their parliament and they used to elect 3000 members in the country अराउंड फ्रॉम होल कंट्री पूरे कंट्री से 3000 मेंबर्स को इलेक्ट किया जाता है एवरी 5 years तो यहां तक तो ठीक है दे आर इलेक्टिंग 3000 मेंबर्स बाय थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ द इलेक्शंस तो दैट इज ओके इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री ये होता है द नेशनल पीपल्स कांग्रेस कमेटी जो है ये द नेशनल पीपल्स कांग्रेस जो है ये 3000 मेंबर्स जो है यहाँ पर है दिस 3000 मेंबर्स हैज द पावर टू अपॉइंट द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द कंट्री ये 3000 लोगों के हाथों में क्या है पावर है They can appoint the president of the country. Okay, यहाँ तक भी ठीक है 3000 members वो लोग हर 5 साल में elect करते हैं और वो 3000 members क्या करते हैं President को elect करते हैं country का That is okay. अभी तक कोई cheating नजर नहीं आ रहा है Some of the members among 3000 members. Now, अब यहाँ से आप देखेंगे ये 3000 members में से कुछ members जो है वो elected होते हैं by the army people used to elect few members and some of the members we don't know they do not disclose about their country that how many members they are electing so we are just saying over here that they used to elect some of the members among 3000 members from army men jo hai wo 3000 mein se kuch members ko elect karte hain let us see aage kya hota hai before contesting elections a candidate needs the approval of the chinese communist party that is the wrong thing over here my dear students ki kisi bhi है ना कैंडिडेट को इलेक्शन में खड़े होने के लिए कॉन्टेस्ट करने के लिए दे विल हैव टू गेट द अप्रूवल फ्रॉम ओनली वन पार्टी दैट इज द चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी से अप्रूवल लेना होगा अगर वो इलेक्शन में खड़ा होने चाहते हैं इफ दे वांट टू कॉन्टेस्ट द इलेक्शन सो ऑल द मेंबर्स हु वांट टू कॉन्टेस्ट दे विल हैव टू टेक अप्रूवल फ्रॉम दिस चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी और भी एक केस है ओनली दोज हु आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ चाइनीज कम्युनिटी पार्टी और 8 स्मॉलर पार्टीज अलाइड टू इट मींस जो उनको सपोर्ट करते हैं जो उनके साथ मिले हुए हैं वैसे 8 और छोटे-छोटे पार्टीज हैं चाइना में सो दोस 8 स्मॉलर पार्टीज एंड द मेंबर ऑफ दोस चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी ये चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी के मेंबर और ये 8 स्मॉलर पार्टीज के मेंबर दे कैन ओनली कॉन्टेस्ट द इलेक्शन यानी इन्हीं लोगों के मेंबर्स जो है वो 3000 मेंबर्स में से चुने जाएंगे मतलब इनके मेंबर्स में से ही 3000 मेंबर्स को इलेक्ट किया जाएगा मींस आप कह सकते हैं द कंट्री ऑफ चाइना इज रूल्ड बाय ओनली वन पार्टी दैट इज चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी कोई दूसरा पार्टी है ही नहीं कोई दूसरे पार्टी अगर बनाएंगे तब भी उनको अप्रूवल नहीं मिलेगा दे विल नॉट गेट द अप्रूवल टू कॉन्टेस्ट द इलेक्शन बिकॉज इट इज रिटेन इन देयर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ही उन्होंने ऐसा बनाया है कि चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी के मेंबर्स या उससे जुड़े हुए जो सपोर्टर्स हैं उनके 8 स्मॉलर पार्टीज और है दे कैन ओनली इलेक्ट द कॉन्टेस्ट द इलेक्शन सो द गवर्नमेंट इज ऑलवेज फॉर्म बाय अब तो क्या होगा कि गवर्नमेंट हमेशा किसका रहेगा चाइनीज कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी का है तो ये अब आप देखें हम लोग यहाँ पर लेट अस सी वेदर चाइना इज वायलेटिंग दिस फीचर feature number two, or whether China is performing according to the feature number two. So let us move to the next example, that is from Mexico. Mexico ka ek example hum log lete hain aur yahan par decide karenge what are they doing over here. Let us see. Since its independence in 1930, Mexico holds election after every 6 years. Chalo yahan se ek saal zyada hai India aur China se. Hai na, wo log har 6 saal mein ek election karate hain aur kya karte hain, they used to elect their president from there. From that election. चलो यहाँ तक ठीक है, election कराते हैं तो president चुनते हैं, that is okay. According to the democracy चल रहा है काम. The country has never been under a military or dictator rule. That is also okay, my dear. अभी भी ठीक है कि country जो है कभी भी जो है किसी military rule या dictator, किसी dictator के अंदर में rule नहीं किया है. The country को किसी ने rule नहीं किया है, नहीं तो कोई military officer और नहीं कोई dictator. That is also okay, my dear. But until 2000, every election was won by a party called PRI. Year 2000 तक एक ही पार्टी जो है वो इलेक्शन जीत रहा था, and the name of that party is PRI, Institutional Revolutionary Party. होना तो चाहिए इसका फुल फॉर्म IRP, लेकिन पता नहीं इसका फुल फॉर्म शॉर्ट में क्यों लिखा है PRI, लेकिन होना चाहिए IRP, है ना, Institutional Revolutionary Party. लेकिन इसका शॉर्ट में क्या लिखा है, PRI पार्टी. लगता है इसका इनका काम भी कुछ उल्टा रहा होगा, है ना, उल्टा सीधा काम करते होंगे. That's why they are also, we are using this PRI. Let us see आगे, अब ये लोग करते क्या है, ये पार्टी क्या करता है. Opposition parties did contest election. ठीक है, ये भी ओके, दैट इज ओके. ऑपोजिशन पार्टी है वो भी कॉन्टेस्ट करते हैं इलेक्शन. It should be there in a democratic type of country. Opposition should be there. Bina opposition ka kuch nahi ho sakta. Phir dictator type ka rule ho sakta hai country mein. So there must be some oppositions also. So opposition parties did contest election but never managed to win. That is the worry over here, my dear students. Yahi par sochni wali baat hai, yahi chinta karni wali baat hai ki why the opposition parties are not winning the election. The PRI was known to use many dirty tricks to win elections. PRI jo party hai, kya uske wo kis na kis se famous hai, that they use dirty tricks to win elections. Bahut sare country mein hote hain, khas karke jo log satte pe hote hain, those who are ruling the country, those who are in power, they used to try and use dirty tricks to win elections every time. And that the same thing was doing by PRI party. Let us see क्या वो लोग करते थे ऐसा कि ये contest, ये election जो है वो हमेशा वही लोग जीता रहे, है ना, why they were winning all the time, what were the dirty tricks played by this PRI party in Mexico. Let us see tricks played by PRI party, that is to win election. क्या क्या tricks करते थे. Trick number one, all those who were employed in government offices had to attend its party meetings. Let us see. अब मेक्सिको में जितने भी गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसेज हैं और वहां पर जितने भी लोग काम करते हैं, दे विल ऑल हैव टू अटेंड द पार्टी मीटिंग एवरी टाइम. जब भी पार्टी मीटिंग होगा, सभी गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसेज को वहां पर मौजूद होना होगा, दे मस्ट बी प्रेजेंट. ओके, पहला तो ये हो गया. सेकंड, टीचर्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट स्कूल यूज्ड टू फोर्स पेरेंट्स. You can see this word over here, my dear students, that they used to force students, teachers of government school used to force parents to vote for PRI. Zabardasti karte the, hai na, government school ke teachers parents se zabardasti karte the ki wo PRI ko hi vote dein. Agar nahi denge vote to kya hoga ki unke bachcho ko ye free education government school mein nahi mil payega. That may be the reason. That's why they were forcing the parents of the government school. Now I'm not talking about private school. I'm talking about government school. Now let us see third trick kya hai. Media largely ignored the activities of opposition political parties. Media bhi unke haathon mein hai. Media kabhi bhi jo hai, they do not write or display or publish any good activities of the opposition party. ऑपोजिशन पार्टी जितना भी अच्छा काम करे, कभी भी मीडिया नहीं दिखाता. मीडिया क्या करता है, दे यूज टू ओनली क्रिटिसाइज देम. हमेशा उनके बारे में बुरा भला लिखते हैं और दिखाते रहते हैं मीडिया. सो मीडिया वॉज ऑल्सो अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ दिस PRI पार्टी ओवर हियर इन मेक्सिको. और देखते हैं, सम टाइम द पोलिंग बूथ्स वर शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर इन द लास्ट मिनट. मतलब 10 मिनट पहले या 1 घंटे पहले जो है व्हाट दे वर डूइंग, दे वर जस्ट शिफ्टिंग द पोलिंग बूथ फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस, मीन चेंजिंग द लोकेशन ऑफ द पोलिंग बूथ. अब ये पोलिंग बूथ क्या है? द पोलिंग बूथ इज दैट प्लेस वेयर पीपल यूज टू गो एंड कास्ट देयर वोट, जहां पर लोग जाके बटन प्रेस करते हैं ना इंडिया में, उसको पोलिंग बूथ कहते हैं हम लोग. तो वो अलग अलग लोकेशन में वो गवर्नमेंट, खास करके गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसेज में, गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में, गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल्स में ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाता है ये पोलिंग बूथ. बट ये पीआरआई पार्टी क्या करते हैं, दे यूज टू चेंज दैट लोकेशन इन द लास्ट मिनट, यानी 1 घंटे पहले हो सकता है या 30 मिनट्स पहले वो चेंज कर देते हैं फार अवे प्लेसेस. अब गया के लोगों को कहा जाए कि पटना जाके वोट करना है वो भी आधा घंटे पहले, देन इट वुड बी रियली वेरी 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 डिफिकल्ट एंड मेनी ऑफ द पीपल वुड नॉट टर्न अप टू कास्ट देयर वोट बिकॉज ऑफ द चेंजिंग ऑफ द लोकेशन. सो दैट मेड इट डिफिकल्ट फॉर पीपल टू कास्ट देयर वोट्स. अब बहुत सारे लोग वोट ही नहीं देते हैं क्योंकि लोकेशन चेंज हो गया. दैट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द डर्टी ट्रिक्स है ना प्लेड बाई पी आर आई पार्टी. दिस इज द फोर्थ वन. और एक ट्रिक वो लोग करते हैं, क्या है द नेक्स्ट वन, लेट अस सी. द पी आर आई स्पेंट अ लार्ज सम ऑफ मनी इन द कैंपेन फॉर इट्स कैंडिडेट. पी आर आई पार्टी के जितने भी कैंडिडेट्स कॉन्टेस्ट करते हैं इलेक्शन, दे यूज टू स्पेंड अ लार्ज सम ऑफ मनी इन कैंपेनिंग, इन एडवर्टाइजिंग है ना, एडवर्टीजमेंट करने के लिए है ना, और पोस्टर्स वगैरह लगाने के लिए दे यूज टू स्पेंड अ लार्ज सम ऑफ मनी टू विन दिस पर्टिकुलर इलेक्शन. दीज आर द फ्यू ऑफ द ट्रिक्स दैट वर प्लेड बाय PRI party. Now I want to ask my students whether they are violating or they are according to the second feature of the of democracy. Whether and you hope that you have liked the video, and we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care. A very good morning to all of you, my dear friends. This is Shafiq Ahmad, and you're all welcome to your favorite YouTube channel, Let's Learn Together. Okay, my dear students, welcome back to the class. And we are just going today to deal with the third and might be the fourth feature of democracies also today. You know? So you can, as you can see over there on the top of the screen on the heading, that we are just moving towards the third feature of democracies. And this is the path that we have chosen to reach to the third feature of democracies. And we need that particular heading, you can see one person, one vote and one value, that is written. What it means that every person should have one vote and the value of that particular one vote should be equal. Everyone, it must not be so that if Shafiq Ahmed is voting, then his voting will be count, his vote will be counted as two votes, and if Supriya will vote, and that her vote will be counted as one vote. It should not be that. That is the third feature of democracy, is just highlighting. And that is not really the quote. The quote is another thing. But here what is written? One person, one vote, one value. It means that whoever is having the right to vote, his vote should have same value. Now let us move ahead towards the topic. What is it saying? We all know that how the struggle for democracy has been linked to the demand of universal adult franchise. Now, whenever we talk about democracy, whenever we talk about equality, then this particular thing, that is the first thing that comes to our mind. What about universal adult franchise? Whether all the adult citizens will be allowed to vote, that comes into our mind. Some people used to think, no, only the male should be allowed to vote. And some people used to say, no, only women should be allowed. And some others say, no, both of them should be allowed. So that is the first thing comes into our mind whenever we start thinking about democracy, or whenever we start thinking about equality. This is the phrase that comes into our mind as and when we start thinking about this democracy or democratic type of country. Let us move ahead, my dear students. The principle, this principle, that principle of universal adult franchise has now came to be accepted almost all over the world. means whoever the country is, they are trying, they are claiming that they are democratic country, and they also accept this particular principle of universal adult franchise, that yes, every adult should be given the right to vote, whether he is a male or female. Right? Male or female, everyone should be allowed to vote. That is the principle which is now being accepted all over the world. But I will still give you few examples where you will find that this particular principle is yet to be implemented, that we are going to just discuss now. There are many examples of denial of equal right to vote. Denial means deny kar rahe hain. Bahut sare aise countries hain jo abhi bhi is cheez ko deny kar rahe hain, that equal right ka opportunity jo hai, you know, equal right to vote ki opportunity hai jo wo sare adults ko milna chahiye. This thing is not still accepted by many countries, that we are going to learn about. And in the meanwhile, I will also show you a few photographs from the internet also. So let me check also. Wait a moment. So my dear students, I was talking about that I'm going to give you few examples about where or which of the countries are there still who are not giving. Until 2015, that is one of the great example, my dear students. Until 2015 in Saudi Arabia, women didn't have the right to vote. 2015 tak women ko right to vote ka option Saudi Arabia mein nahi tha. In September 2011 only, King Abdullah, now if you want to have a look at the King Abdullah, I will show you that also. So King Abdullah granted women the right to vote, and also he granted that they can also stand in the 2015 municipal elections. Now just let me remind you about this municipal elections, what it means. King Abdullah just granted women to right to vote, and for vote what? For voting to elect the candidate for 2015 municipal elections. Yani 2015 mein hi unko option mila women ko ki wo bhi vote kar sakti hain. Aur vote kiske liye karna hai? For electing the commissioner of municipal election, and a municipal commissioner. Yani municipal commissioner ke head ko jo chunna hai, elect karna hai, wo 2015 mein unko mila tha. Ab ye municipal election kaun, inka kaam kya hota hai? What is the function of that municipal municipal department to maintain the roads, to maintain the street lights, and to maintain the vestiges of the city. So that is a different department, that the municipal corporation department, that we are also having in India also. So only that particular right was given to the woman by this Mr. King Abdullah, the King of Saudi Arabia. Now I'm going to show you with the help of Google Chrome browser also online. I'm going to show you about King Abdullah, few details that you would like to share, that you would like to have a few details about King Abdullah also. Let me share it. I just click on the link and it will just come up. So the link is not, oh yes, it is there. Now you can see over that particular link over there. Actually I clicked twice or thrice, I think. So you can see over here about Saudi municipal election about, and you can see over here about King Abdullah also. His details are also given. Let me show you about King Abdullah also. What is it? That article is showing there. This is first about the Saudi Arabian municipal election. Elections were held in Saudi Arabia. You can see over there that elections were held in Saudi Arabia in December 2015. You can see in the screen over there. Let me close this one. Yeah. For municipal councils, which have limited, let me zoom it also. Which have limited decision making powers. So election Saudi Arabia mein kiske liye kiya gaya tha? For electing the municipal corporation head. So on 12 December 2015, municipal corporation have limited decision making powers on local issues such as rubbish collection. And ghar se jo wastage nikalte hain, rubbish nikalte hain, usko collection karne ke liye ek team banaya ja raha hai municipal corporations mein, and maintaining the streets also. So sirf in cheezon ke liye, the previous two elections, 2015 or 2011, were for half the council seats and were open to male candidates. So 2011 में भी election हुआ था, लेकिन उसमें क्या था? Only male candidates were allowed. But in 2015, the The option was given to the male as well as both female candidates. You can see over here, the 2015 election was for both, for two-thirds of the council seats on 284 municipal councils, with both male and female candidates as well as voters. क्या था कि अब वो कैंडिडेट एज ए कैंडिडेट वुमेन कैन ऑल्सो अप्लाई एज ए कैंडिडेट दैट शी वुड बी मेंटेनिंग दिस रबिश कलेक्शन एंड स्ट्रीट मेंटेनेंस है ना बाय बिकमिंग द म्युनिसिपल ऑफिसर एंड दे कैन ऑल्सो वुमेन कैन ऑल्सो वोट सो थैंक्स अ लॉट ऑफ थैंक्स टू किंग अब्दुल्ला बिकॉज ही हैज गिवन सच राइट टू द वुमेन है ना सो लेट अस सी वन ऑफ द फोटोग्राफ ऑफ किंग अब्दुल्ला ऑल्सो ही डिजर्व दैट ही हैज ग्रेट डन द ग्रेट थिंग एक्चुअली ही स्टार्टेड Or he has taken the initiative. Here is this King Abdullah. You can see over here. That is the King of Saudi Arabia in 2015. And his successor is Salman, King Salman, who is just now at the present ruling the country. King Salman is his son, and he is this King Abdullah. You can see over there. So hope you got about the particular this Saudi Arabia. Now let us move towards Estonia. Estonia has made its citizenship rules in such a way that people belonging to Russian minority, they find it difficult to get the right to vote. Estonia mein kya hota hai? Abhi, where is this particular country, Estonia? Let me show you the details about Estonia also. By just clicking on the link, I will show you about Estonia also. Estonia is a country on the western coast of Baltic Sea in Northern Europe. Means it is an European country, Estonia. Ab Estonia mein kya hota hai? That Russian minority ke log jo wahan rehte hain, Russian log jo rehte hain us particular country mein, they find it difficult to get the right to vote. Means the people, the original citizens of Estonia, they get the right to vote, but these Russian minority people who are living in Estonia, they do not get the right to vote. So that is also the condition of that particular country, Estonia. Now let us move away to our next topic, that is in Fiji. Ab chalo ye dekhte hain Fiji kahan par hai. Let us see, jo bhi mind mein hai, let us clear it. Where is this country Fiji? Let's just come up, just coming up about Fiji. We are going to see. It is an island country in Melanesia, that is part of Oceania in South Pacific Ocean. And it is a Republic of Fiji, a democratic country. It is 1,100 nautical miles away from northwest of New Zealand and North Island. And around New Zealand ke aaspaas mein ye country hai na, part of Oceania. Ab yahan Fiji mein kya hota hai? Let us see what happened in Fiji. The electoral system is such that the vote of an indigenous, that is original Fiji, has more value than that of an Indian Fijian. Yani jo Indian yahan se jaake wahan bas gaye hain, those who have become the citizen of Fiji, they have less value of their votes. Means original Fiji ka ek vote hai na, two count kiya jayega ya three count ho sakta hai, but Indian Fijian jo hai, they also have the right to vote, but their vote is not having that equal value. तो ये हम लोगों ने देखा कि 1% वन वोट और वन वैल्यू वाला जो मामला है दैट इज नॉट प्रूविंग टू बी गुड इन सऊदी अरेबिया एस्टोनिया एज वेल एज इन फिजी ऑल्सो सो हम लोग नहीं कह सकते दैट एवरी कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड नाउ हैज बिकम डेमोक्रेटिक एंड एवरीवन इज गिविंग द राइट टू वोट टू एवरी ऑर्डर सिटीजन एंड ईच वोट इज इक्वल ऑल्सो इज ऑल्सो हैविंग इक्वल वैल्यू वी कांट से बिकॉज देयर आर फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस दैट वी हैव जस्ट सीन माई स्टूडेंट्स सो वी कांट से दैट इट इज रियली someone is asking, is there any place where women had right to vote and men had to struggle for it? I don't think there is no such place, my dear students, that women has struggled, that men has struggled for getting the right to vote. But in many countries where there is a system of what? There is a system of labor or slavery is there, then those slaves, even women or men, they do not have the right to vote. Only in that condition men do not have the right to vote, but in other conditions men was always having a right to vote, and every time women have to fight to get the right to vote. We have seen in the French Revolution also, and we will see further also. So that is our feature number three. What is he saying? Feature number three, democracy is based on a fundamental principle of political equality. Means politically sab log kya hona chahiye, equal hona chahiye. Even men and even women, they should both get the opportunity to administer, to take part in the affairs of the government means every male and female, both adult citizens, should be given political equality. सबको चांस मिलना चाहिए. एंड हियर कम्स आवर फीचर नंबर थ्री. और यहीं से हम लोगों को फीचर नंबर थ्री भी मिलता है. दैट गिव्स अस द थर्ड फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. इन ए डेमोक्रेसी ईच ऑर्डर सिटीजन मस्ट हैव वन वोट एंड ईच वोट मस्ट हैव वन वैल्यू. दैट इज द थर्ड फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. एंड सऊदी अरेबिया, एस्टोनिया एंड फिजी आर वायलेटिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर थर्ड फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. दैट आई वॉन्ट टू से. एंड वी आर फॉर्चुनेट इनफ माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स दैट इन इंडिया, इंडिया पास दिस पर्टिकुलर थर्ड फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. I think so. So I am also okay. Let us move ahead, my dear students, towards the next feature of democracy. Hope you understand. And if you really want to say something, then comment also. Feature of democracy, that one person, one vote and one value that we just have gone through. And there is a very beautiful image over there, painting, and that is the cartoonist is making something and editing, like many of our students also used to do. So what is there and what is the message here over in this cartoon? You can see over here, at last one man one vote means they are enjoying, the people of those countries, those who had suddenly recently got the right to vote, every adult citizen, they are just enjoying and saying at last one man one vote. And who is there behind the bar? You can see someone is there behind the bar. I liked it. That person who is behind the bar is saying, I liked it better when I was the one man and the one vote. अब इनको ये समझ में आ रहा है कि ये बहुत अच्छा था जब when I was one man and I was having one vote. The person is saying. और ये आदमी है कौन behind the bar? Let us see in this photograph, this image, this message. The message is there, my dear student. The cartoon is about the Iraqi election. ये cartoon किसके बारे में? Iraqi elections के बारे में है. और Iraqi elections में क्या हो रहा था? Held after Saddam Hussein regime was overthrown. सद्दाम हुसैन के गवर्नमेंट को जब ओवरथ्रो कर दिया गया था, हटा दिया गया था, उसके बाद ये इलेक्शन होता है इराक में. एंड ही इज शोन बिहाइंड द बार्स. सो सद्दाम हुसैन इज बीइंग शोन ओवर हियर बिहाइंड द बार्स. एंड वुमेन एज वेल एज मेन आर एंजॉयिंग द राइट टू वोट इन इराक. एंड व्हाट आर दे सेइंग एट लास्ट वी गॉट वन मैन वन वोट. यानी कि अब यहाँ पर उनके पास में ये मौजूद हो गया था, दे आर अवेलेबल दैट एवरी वोट इज इक्वली वैल्यूएबल. है ना, सभी वोट का एक ही जैसा कीमत है. एवरी वोट इज हैविंग इक्वल वैल्यू. ओके, दैट इज द थर्ड फीचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. एंड नाउ लेट अस मूव आवर टुवर्ड्स द फोर्थ वन. दैट इज द फोर्थ डेमोक्रेसी. इज देयर समथिंग मूविंग देयर? फीचर नंबर फोर, अ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट रूल्स विद इन लिमिट्स बाय कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लॉ एंड सिटीजन राइट्स. दैट इज द फोर्थ वन. क्या कह रहे हैं यहाँ पर कि डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट को क्या करना चाहिए? दे मस्ट रूल विद इन लिमिट्स, अपने लिमिट्स में रहना चाहिए. एंड व्हाट आर देयर लिमिट्स? देयर लिमिट्स आर ऑलवेज सेट बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ दैट कंट्री. है ना, ये गवर्नमेंट, डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट के लिमिट्स को कैसे सेट किया जाता है? बाय सेटिंग अप द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लॉ एंड सिटीजंस राइट्स. तो ये गवर्नमेंट को दो चीज को ध्यान में रख के काम करना चाहिए. है ना, दे मस्ट एक्ट अकॉर्डिंगली अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन as well as the right of the citizen of the country. ye do cheez ko chhod kar agar wo karenge, then they will just destroy the democracy of the country. So a democratic government rule within limits. They must rule within limits. aisa nahi hai ki you have won the election, you have been elected by the people, now you will just dominate, you will cheat them. That is not so. They will have to rule within limits set by this constitutional law as well as citizen rights. Citizen ke right ke hisab se aur constitution ke hisab se unko rule karna hai, government ko run karna hai, logon ko fayda pahunchana hai. aisa nahi hai ki aapko elect kar liya gaya hai to aap chahenge jo bhi chahenge wo sab kuch kar sakte hain. That is not so, my dear students. So let us understand this case with the case study case of Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe attained independence from white minority rule in the year 1980. तो इस particular feature को पढ़ने के लिए, हम लोग समझने के लिए जिम्बाब्वे का एक example लेते हैं. That is case study. So Zimbabwe got independence in the year 1980 from whom? From white minority rule. यानी white लोगों से. White लोगों से उनको एक क्या छुटकारा मिला था? They got independence from white minority rule in the year 1980. And since then, और तब से 1980 से 2020 2000 20 अभी चल रहा है बट नॉट टिल ईयर, ये सब कुछ खत्म हो गया जो अभी डिस्कस करने हम लोग. सिंस दे द कंट्री हैज बीन रूल्ड बाय जानू पीएफ. अब ये क्या है जानू पीएफ? जानू इज द शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ ए नेम ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर पार्टी. क्या है? जिम्बाब्वे अफ्रीकन नेशनल यूनियन पैट्रियोटिक फ्रंट, है ना. जानू का मतलब क्या है? जिम्बाब्वे अफ्रीकन नेशनल यूनियन. और पीएफ क्यों लगा है? पैट्रियोटिक फ्रंट, दैट इज द नेम ऑफ द पार्टी दैट लेड द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल. दिस पार्टी वॉज लार्जली इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द fighting for the freedom and getting to get the freedom, and this party was largely responsible and they were involved in the struggle of getting freedom or getting independence. So that's why this party is just ruling Zimbabwe since 1980 se abhi tak isi company isi party ka rule chal raha hai. Lekin dekhte hain kab tak chala hai inka rule. Its leader, unke leader kaun hai? Robert Mugabe. He is the leader and who is ruling the country since independence. And independence ke baad se aaj tak jo hai, not aaj tak, later on I will tell you kab tak. So Robert Mugabe ruled the country since independence. Ye abhi jaan ke rakhna hai ki that Robert Mugabe was ruling the country since independence. Independence ke baad se रॉबर्ट मुगाबे जो है उनकी गवर्नमेंट है, यानी कि उनकी पार्टी जो है हमेशा जीतते चले आए. और let me show you few details about Robert Mugabe, the then president or the head of the government of Zimbabwe. And here you can see his photograph also, his image is also there, Robert Mugabe. You can see over here, Robert Gabriel Mugabe is his full name. And he was a Zimbabwean revolutionary and politician. तो ये रेवोल्यूशन से बहुत जुड़े हुए हैं, इसलिए ही वॉज वेरी पॉपुलर. वो बहुत पॉपुलर लीडर भी रह चुके हैं एंड ही वॉज ए पॉलिटिशियन ऑल्सो एंड ही सर्व्ड एज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ जिम्बाब्वे फ्रॉम 1982-1987 एंड देन एज प्रेसिडेंट फ्रॉम 1987-2017. अब आपको अंदाजा लग गया होगा कि ये मिस्टर रॉबर्ट मुगाबे जो है वो 2017 तक, यानी 1980 से, फ्रॉम 1980 से लेकर 2017 तक ये रूल करते चले आए. एंड लेट अस सी कि एक ही आदमी एक ही पार्टी क्यों जीत रहा था. इलेक्शंस वर हेल्ड रेगुलरली बट ऑलवेज वॉन बाय दिस जानू पीएफ पार्टी. इलेक्शंस तो होते थे लेकिन हमेशा ये इलेक्शन कौन जीत रहा था? दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्टी, जानू पीएफ पार्टी. अब क्यों जीत रहा था जरा देखते हैं हम लोग. प्रेसिडेंट मुगाबे वाज पॉपुलर बट आल्सो यूज्ड अनफेयर प्रैक्टिसेस इन इलेक्शंस. रॉबर्ट मुगाबे पॉपुलर तो थे क्योंकि ही वाज ए रेवोल्यूशनरी, है ना, रिवॉल्ट करने वाले थे, यानी वो बहुत बड़े लीडर रह चुके हैं अपने जमाने में टू गेट जिम्बाब्वे इट्स इंडिपेंडेंस, है ना. जिम्बाब्वे को इंडिपेंडेंस दिलाने में बहुत इनका रोल अदा किया उन्होंने. ही हैज ग्रेटर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी देयर बट after winning the independence he is just using unfair practices in elections. Let us see ab wo kya karte the zara dekhte hain hum log. What was the unfair practices he was using? Let us see trick played by president Robert Mugabe of Zimbabwe. Kya kya trick karte the wo? Over the years his government changed the constitution several times to increase the power of the president. Bahut baar unhone kya kiya hai, apne government mein rehte hue constitution ko change kiya, modified the constitution to increase the power of the president. President ke power ko badhane ke liye bahut baar inhone kya kiya, constitution mein changes laya hai taki president ko zyada power mil sake, yani Robert Mugabe ko, and make him less accountable. That is one of the greatest feature of democracy, ki government ko, democratic government ko accountable hona padta hai. They are accountable, they will have to give reason to the public. But here by changing the constitution, by modifying the constitution, Robert Mugabe was making him less accountable. Yani ab inko zyada jawab nahi dena hai government ke taraf se logon ko. Public protest, डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन दोनों को उन्होंने डिक्लेयर कर दिया कि इलीगल है. लोग प्रोटेस्ट नहीं कर सकते, डेमोन्स्ट्रेट नहीं कर सकते, इलीगल हो गया. लॉ एक उन्होंने बनाया कि आप क्रिटिसाइज नहीं कर सकते प्रेसिडेंट को, लिमिटेड यू कैन क्रिटिसाइज द प्रेसिडेंट इन ए लिमिटेड वे, अनलिमिटेड वे में आप क्रिटिसाइज नहीं कर सकते प्रेसिडेंट को, अदरवाइज यू विल बी पनिश्ड. और उन्होंने क्या क्या, टेलीविजन रेडियो वर कंट्रोल बाय द गवर्नमेंट, यानी वो वही दिखाते हैं जो रूलिंग पार्टी जो है कहना चाहता था, जो रूलिंग पार्टी का वर्शन होता था. दिस टेलीविजन एंड रेडियो वॉज फुल्ली कंट्रोल बाय द गवर्नमेंट, यानी ये अब कभी भी इनके खिलाफ कुछ नहीं बोलते थे. टेलीविजन एंड रेडियो मीन्स आप कह सकते हैं सेंसरशिप वॉज देयर. देयर वर फ्यू इंडिपेंडेंट न्यूज पेपर, कुछ न्यूज पेपर इंडिपेंडेंट होते थे बट द गवर्नमेंट यूज टू हैरास दोस जर्नलिस्ट, गवर्नमेंट हैरास करते थे जर्नलिस्ट को जो उनके खिलाफ जाते थे, उनको परेशान करते थे. द गवर्नमेंट इग्नोर्ड सम कोर्ट जजमेंट्स ऑल्सो, गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ कोर्ट जजमेंट्स को भी इग्नोर कर दिया था जब कोर्ट ने इनके खिलाफ कुछ आदेश दिया था. इफ द कोर्ट हैज डिसाइडेड अगेंस्ट समथिंग देन दे ऑल्सो इग्नोर्ड द कोर्ट जजमेंट ऑल्सो and went against it and pressurized judges. और यहाँ तक कि जज को भी वो लोग नहीं छोड़ते थे, जज को भी वो लोग क्या करते थे, प्रेशराइज करते थे. यानी जज को भी कुछ कहने का मौका नहीं है, प्रेशर में वो भी काम करना पड़ता था उनको. At last, President Robert Mugabe was forced out of office in 2017. लेकिन लास्ट में वही होता है जो सबके साथ होता है, है ना, क्योंकि डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट में सिटीजन्स का सब कुछ चलता है. लेकिन कुछ दिन के लिए आप उनको चुप करा सकते हैं, यू कैन मेक देम क्वाइट फॉर सम टाइम ओनली. सो इन 2017 ही वॉज फोर्स्ड आउट ऑफ ऑफिस इन 2017 बाय द पीपल ऑफ जिम्बाब्वे. सो वी हैव व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड ओवर हियर दैट यस इन डेमोक्रेसी rulers are there, but these rulers, they must act according to the constitution. They should not modify the constitution for their benefits. अपने benefits के लिए उनको modify नहीं करना चाहिए constitution का. So what is the conclusion? Zimbabwe showed that they are having popular approval, but ruler is necessary also, but that is not sufficient. ऐसा नहीं कि आप ruler बन गए तो आप जो भी चाहेंगे वो कुछ भी करेंगे आप, है ना. You should not think like this. ऐसा नहीं कर सकते आप. पॉपुलर गवर्नमेंट कैन बी अनडेमोक्रेटिक, है ना. जो गवर्नमेंट पॉपुलर होता है, बहुत फेमस होता है, वो अनडेमोक्रेटिक धीरे धीरे हो जाता है, डेमोक्रेसी से हट जाता है ना, दे मूव अवे फ्रॉम डेमोक्रेसी. पॉपुलर लीडर्स कैन बी ऑटोक्रेटिक, मीन्स डिक्टेटर बन जाएंगे वो पॉपुलर लीडर, जैसे कि रॉबर्ट मुगाबे के केस में हुआ, है ना. सेंसरशिप लगा दिया, आप डेमोन्स्ट्रेट नहीं कर सकते, प्रोटेस्ट नहीं कर सकते, दैट इज ऑटोक्रेटिक रूल, दैट इज डिक्टेटर टाइप ऑफ रूल. एसेस, अगर आप डेमोक्रेसी को एसेस करना चाहते हैं, चेक करना चाहते हैं, देन इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट यू शुड लुक एट द इलेक्शन. एक इलेक्शन को आप ध्यान में रखें अगर आप देखना चाहते हैं एक कंट्री डेमोक्रेटिक है या नहीं. इट इज इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट टू लुक बिफोर एंड आफ्टर द इलेक्शन. इलेक्शन के पहले भी, इलेक्शन के बाद भी आपको ध्यान रखना चाहिए कि दूसरे लोगों को, अपोजिशन पार्टीज आर गेटिंग चांसेस, है ना, फेयर चांसेस टू विन द इलेक्शन ऑल्सो, है ना. दे शुड रेस्पेक्ट बेसिक राइट्स ऑफ द सिटीजन ऑल्सो. और सिटीजन के पास में ये पूरा हक होना चाहिए दैट दे शुड बी फ्री टू थिंक, to have opinion, to express this in public, to form association, है ना. लोग जो है अपना thinking को, अपने opinions को रख सके, association बना सके, party बना सके, protest कर सके, ये सारा हक होना चाहिए एक constitutional country में, एक democratic country में, और कोई भी वो political action ले सके. That is all in this class about the fourth feature of democracy, my dear students. And if you have any questions, then please write in the comment box also, and you can write over here in the chat box also, so that we can. Hope that you have liked the video, and we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye bye. Take care. A very good morning to all of you, my dear friends. This is Shafiq Ahmad, and you are all welcome to your favorite YouTube channel, Let's Learn Together. So, welcome back to all of you, my students, and very good morning to all of you also. So, that is the conclusion we were going through about the fourth feature of democracy. After the fourth feature of democracy, we are just concluding the things so that we can come to the next section of the chapter. And that section is quite really very interesting and amazing one also. So I will include everyone, and I will take everyone's house and comments also. So what I have to conclude after that, the features of democracy, we have learned and discussed about what is democracy also and its features also. So what we have concluded in the chapter, that everyone should be equal in the eyes of law in a democratic country. We are just talking about a democratic country and nothing else. So in a democratic country, everyone should be equal in the eyes of the law. That is the first thing that we have come to learn, no? By analyzing different countries and their parliament as well as their constitution. And we have compared our country also with all the four features of democracy in our previous classes. So what we have concluded by learning all the features, that everyone should be equal in the eyes of law. And the other thing that we want to also conclude, that the right must be protected. Means the right that we are enjoying, the rights such as freedom to express our views, freedom to express our views and publish also, and we can also form association, we can make our own parties also, and we can criticize the government also. That is one of the most important right that we are having over here, that we can criticize the government. We can protest, we can demonstrate. Means all these rights must be protected by an independent judiciary. So let me remind you, my students, that I'm talking about judiciary, independent judiciary, not only normal judiciary. The judiciary system of a democratic country should be independent. No one should pressurize them to change their opinion, to change their justice. That is what I am talking about over here, that the rights must be protected. Our rights, that we have just discussed, the rights must be protected by an independent judiciary, judiciary such as which should not be pressurized by anyone, by any of the government. No one should pressurize them to change their justice or giving their opinions. So, and the justice should be obeyed by everyone and should be followed by everyone, should be accepted by everyone. That is all in this particular second point of conclusion that I want to conclude over here. The next one, what we have concluded again, that there must be some conditions that should apply also after the elections, means after the winner is declared, then there should also be some conditions. And what are those conditions? Those conditions, I'm talking about those conditions which are written in our constitution, in the constitution of a country, and even in the citizen rights, means the rights that the citizen is having, and the constitution, whatever is written in that particular document in our constitution, should be applied after the election. And no one should try to stop that election, stop that particular government. That is the third thing that we want over here. Next one is what? A democratic government cannot do whatever it likes. They should not do. Because because they have won the election. That always goes on in many of the countries. After winning the election, that particular government who won the election, who used to win the election, they used to start doing like the dictators. They used to start doing whatever they likes. But in a democratic government, it should not be there. A democratic government cannot do whatever it likes. They should always consult the citizen of the country, either directly or by asking or taking opinion from the representative of the citizens. That's another point that we have to conclude over here. And the fifth one is what? We have to respect some basic rules. Means we'll have to respect that guarantees to the minorities also. Means those who are minor in our country, like Christians and Sikhs, they are not in quite major population in our country. So what we have to do, that we should respect them also. We should respect and think about them also. We should frame whatever act or rules or law in our country by thinking about them also. That those minorities should not be heard, and those minorities should not be discriminated against any particular law or rule of the country. So that is another thing that we should think about the minorities also. Every major decision has to go through a series of consultations. Major decisions, I'm talking about major decisions that everyone in a particular, especially in a democratic country, that the major decision should be under a series of consultation. And if a lot of people, if all the representative of the people, citizen of the country, will sit together and consult together, then they can make a quality decision. The decision will be a quality one, because a lot of people will be there, engaged there, and they will all discuss many points, positive as well as a negative point. And after those heavy discussion, they can come to a conclusion, and that particular decision will be a quite quality decision. So that is also one of the most important feature, or you can say characteristic of this particular democratic type of government. Another one, every office bearer has certain rights and responsibilities, and they are assigned those rights and responsibilities by the constitution and the law.
office bearer, I mean to say over here, such as the DM of the country, the chief minister, the DM of a particular state, and the chief minister or other who are just holding office, they must all abide by the rules and regulations, whatever is written in the constitution. They should abide by the law also. So they should be accountable, that I mean to say over here, that everyone should be accountable over there, and they will have to answer to the government, to the people, especially to the people. Each of these is accountable, and not only to the people, but also, you can see over here, they should be accountable not only to the people, but other independent officials also. Means whoever is above them, they will have to answer to their seniors also. And the most important, that every office bearer should be accountable, should be answerable to the people also. We have the one right in our country, right to information, that we can ask the government, we can ask any particular department of any government about the uses of their power, how are they using the power, and what are they doing for the people of the country, for the citizen of the country. We can ask any such information, and that is included in our act also, that is Right to Information Act, that have been implemented in India. Okay, let us move to our next topic. What we have to summarize over here, that what is democracy? After going through many of the features of democracy, four features we have gone through. So let us summarize what we have learned till now, that rulers elected by the people should take all the major decisions in a democratic form of government. That is most important, my dear students, that the rulers whom we have elected, they should all have the power to take major decisions. Means those rulers should not be pressurized by some other foreigners or from other such as industrialists. Many time industrialists used to what? Pressurize the government, pressurize the rulers whom we used to elect. Such as in India also, I don't want to take any name, but you are all clever enough. You know that who is pressurizing the government to change decisions. Many times industrialists and even some political other parties also, they used to change the government decisions by pressurizing them. So what we have discussed over here, come to know about democracy, that democracy is a form of government in which the rulers elected by the people should take all the major decisions. That is the first summary that I want to include over here. Number two, elections should offer a choice and fair opportunity to the people to change the current ruler. हाँ, हम लोगों के पास में ये पूरा फेयर अपॉर्चुनिटीज होना चाहिए, चांसेस होना चाहिए कि हम लोग गवर्नमेंट को चेंज कर सके, रूलर्स को चेंज कर सके. और वी हैव सीन इन मेनी प्लेसेस, वी हैव सीन इन मेक्सिको आल्सो, वी हैव सीन इन चाइना आल्सो, दैट ओनली वन पार्टी इज रूलिंग द कंट्री. ओनली वन पार्टी इन चाइना इज रूलिंग द कंट्री फ्रॉम मेनी मेनी इयर्स. सो दिस इज नॉट ए डेमोक्रेटिक टाइप ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. दे कांट से दैट दे फॉलो डेमोक्रेसी, where elections should offer a choice and fair opportunity to people and to change the current rulers, where there should not be any misuse of EVM, and there should not be last minute change of the voting center and a voting center also, that we have also discussed in our chapter, in this chapter only, that in one of the country they were just changing the voting location, where people used to go to vote, they used to change the location at the last minute. So that is not the thing should be gone in democracy. In democracy, the fair chance should be given to the people, to the citizen of the country, so that they can change the government if they wish so. Means they can ask the government after 5 years of time in India, they can ask the government what have they done, and they can just analyze this. Why should they ask? They themselves can analyze the government, and they can analyze that whether what they have done the work or not. Let us see the third point that we have to summarize over here. The choice and opportunity is available to all the people on equal basis. Is the choice as well as the opportunity should be available to all the people on equal basis, that everyone should be provided equal opportunity and equal choice suppose you want to take admissions and in medical colleges after completing your graduation or after completing your plus two, then you should be given equal opportunity. Aapko ye keh ke nahi nikal diya jaye ki no, you can't be there. Let me share the screen. हाँ ऐसा आपको डेट कोई आपको ये बोलकर नहीं छोड़ दे निकाल दे कि नो 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 यू बिलोंग टू दलित कम्युनिटी यू बिलोंग टू दैट पर्टिकुलर कास्ट एंड रिलीजन एंड यू विल नॉट बी गिवन फेयर चांस टू गेट एडमिशन इन द मेडिकल कॉलेज इन दिस कॉलेज सो दैट आई वांट टू से ओवर हियर इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक टाइप ऑफ कंट्री द चॉइस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटी शुड बी अवेलेबल टू ईच एंड एवरी वन इन द कंट्री नेक्स्ट द एक्सरसाइज of the choice leads to a government limited by basic rules of the constitution as well as citizen rights now whoever have been elected by the people in the government and suppose we have elected BJP government in our country okay that is all okay we have elected them but they should be limited by the basic rules they should run the government within limitation they should follow the constitution and they should abide by the citizen rights also whatever they will do in the government in the country to run the country they will have to abide by the constitution unko jo hai constitution se abide karna hoga they will have to follow the constitution otherwise that is right quite not possible my dear that we will have such a independent country or a democratic type of country so yes someone said in the chat also that china about china let me see in china the communist party of china is ruling since 1949 yes you are quite my dear aditya singh you are right that china is there is only one party in china who is ruling the country since 1949 yes you are right okay let us move ahead to our next topic Chinese government, yes, someone was talking about China, and then we are just coming about the Chinese government only. What you can see in this image, what you feel over here, that a tank is coming, you know, tank. एक सामने में देख सकते हैं आपकी tank है, and there is a citizen of the country, एक बच्चा खड़ा है, that is the adult citizen, maybe adult said, let him take as an adult, or he is citizen of the country, he is standing unarmed, इसके हाथ पे कोई हथियार नहीं है. He's just not having any type of arm in his hands. And what this particular image shows us that Chinese government have blocked free flow of information on the internet by placing restrictions on popular websites like Yahoo and Google. Chinese government ne kya kiya block kar diya that the people of China can't use Google as well as Yahoo because they are popular websites they are popular search engine also so we can search a lot of information about other countries also about the forms of the government and the other countries also so that the people of China can't get information about other rulers or about the other things in the country also. Roshni is saying that what if a representative is elected once and after some time citizen realize that the representative whom they have elected is not suitable for them. Means if they feel they are not fair representative before 5 years or the time period, so any can the citizen of the country remove them and choose any other perfect leader? That is a good question, my dear Roshni. That is a real good one, and I want to answer you that. If you don't like, if you have elected a particular government, what happens in India really, what is going on, that we choose a particular government and that particular government, they used to choose their ministers, and a railway minister or other education minister, they used to check and and choose their ministers from themselves. We are just electing the particular party to rule to your country. We are actually not electing those ministers. हम लोग वो ministers को elect नहीं करते. But people can every time can do anything in a democratic country. We can start protest. We can start demonstrating against that particular minister who is not doing his or her work according to the constitution or who is just cheating the government, then we can ask them, we can pressurize such type of government or such type of ministers, and we can ask and pressurize that particular party also whom we have elected, and they will be forced to change that particular railway minister or education minister or any minister. He will be forced to leave his particular seat. So we can, but we will have to do protest or ask the particular government who is running the government, as we will have to ask that party to change the minister and take necessary actions against those who are misusing the power. Hope that you have liked the video, and we will meet again in our next video release.
of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care. A very good morning to all of you, my dear friends. This is Shafiq Ahmad, and you're all welcome to your favorite YouTube channel, Let's Learn Together. So, as you can see over here, arguments which are against democracy, or what are the demerits of democracy. We have discussed a lot about the demerits as well as demerits of democracy. So, just here we are going to highlight those points so that we can just keep them in our mind, so that you can also pen down in your examination. Leaders keep changing in a democracy. That is one of the point which is going against the democratic type of government. We also know that when a particular leader does not perform his roles and responsibilities in a good manner, you know, or whatever he has kept done the promises, and if he is not fulfilling, then the people, the citizen of that country, they used to ask for his resignation. And it leads to change of leader within that 5 years of a span of time. So that is one of the thing which is going against democracy, because if a same leader will keep on doing his work for the 5 years, then he will know the things better, in a better way. He will know the ups and downs, and even the test of the public or the demand of the time also. So if he is not there for the full time of his office, that is for 5 years, then it will really be a disadvantage for the people also. But on the same hand, we can also say that if the leaders is not performing his roles and responsibilities as per the demand, then he should be not in that office. So that is a both side coin, we can say. There is a positive remark also in this leaders keep changing in democracy. And we can also say that there is something which is going against that also. Okay, so this is the first point which is going against the demerits of, which is going against the democracy. So if you have any points over here, then you can tell me over here. Raise your hand, then I will allow if you want to share something. Anyone? Okay, no ways. Let us move to the next point of demerit of democracy. Democracy is all about political competition and power play. There is no scope of morality, that is humanity, ethics, honesty. Democracy is all about competition. Here, there are different parties in every country, somewhere 5, somewhere 10. In China, we also know that there is only one party. But in India, there are many, many parties. You know? Those who claim to be there, and everyone used to make promises. And they compete with each other. They use all their power to win the election also. Whether they use it in a fair way or unfair way, but they try to use all their power and try to win the election. Even they can execute people also. Even they do not have any type of morality. Insaniyat. Insaniyat naam ka koi cheez nahi rehta hai. Ye log insaniyat aur mercy, morality, is par koi dhyan nahi dete. They just can do anything to win the election. So that is also one of the point that is going against democracy. That these political leaders, if they try to use all their power to win any election, and in that election they really can do anything that you might be knowing, that what can do they can do to win a particular election. So that is quite dangerous and going against the democracy. But on the other hand, you will say that there should be a competition, there should be other parties also, there should be opposition party also. So that is also going in favor. But here,
if you will say that yeah, they are not using or they are not having humanity, morality, insaniyat, honesty, ye sab bhul jate hain log in democratic type of governance. Next, that is quite important, that lots of people have to be consulted while making a decision in a democratic type of government. Yes, that is right. If a decision has to be made, then first of all, there are different type of levels of government from where it has to be passed, and a lot of people are consulted in the time being, and which lead to delay to make a particular decision in a democratic type of government. Sometimes it take whole year also. Kabhi kabhi to ek saal bhi lag jata hai ek decision ko frame out karne ke liye, final karne ke liye. So which really lead to delays, and it can be a hurdle in the progress of the country also, because sometimes we need to take decisions at quick time also, but at that particular need of the time also, we will have to wait and consult each and every people, at least all the government houses, even chief ministers, prime ministers, and there are many MLAs are also there in the parliament, and there is a voting system. So it takes time to take a particular decision, and which can sometime be good, which can sometime be very bad for the country also. Next point is what? Elected leaders do not know the best interest of the people, the leaders whom we elect. So actually what really happened in India, the particular elected or the leader who is just going to stand at the election and will ask for the vote, they make promises. But after winning the election, they really forget, and many of them perform also. It is not so that every leader used to just forget all the promises and do not perform anything. But out of 10, you can say that only 2 or 3 people used to perform or do their jobs according to their promises or according to the time. But most of the time is that leaders, they do not know the best interest of the people. Unko pata nahi hota hai ki logon ko kya behtareen cheez chahiye, what is the best for the people, and which leads to bad decisions. Because what really happened now, after the election, they do not come to your house, they do not come to your locality area to find out the problems. They just sit at their particular office, they just enjoy the chair, the facilities that the government they provide to those leaders. If they will come to your house, if they will come to your locality, if they will come to your area, then only they would be knowing that what is the real need of the people, and then only they can make good decisions regarding the people. But in this case, if they do not come, if they do not interfere in the matters of the people, they would not be knowing the best interest of the people, and which really can lead them to take bad decisions also. Means that is the decision which can go against the people also. So that is also one of the point which is going against democracy. Next one is what? Democracy leads to corruption. Yes, that is most important also, I think. Corruption can really lead a country to its back foot. Corruption say a country jo hai bahut piche chala jata hai. And democracy leads to corruption, as it is based on electoral competition. Because electoral competition hota hai, log voting system karte hain, aur you must be knowing and learning about that many of the tricks are played by the winners, you know, those who are in the existing government. They used to play a lot of tricks and unfair means to win the elections, which really lead to corruptions. Because we need the right people at the right post. Right people at the right place can do the right thing. But over here, what we can see over here, that we just elect the person, and that elected person is not really knowing about the people of that particular area also. If you are voting for a particular party, so that party choose their own leader to rule, or you can say to take decisions of the people of that particular area. So it really leads to corruption also, which is not for the people, not for the not good for the people as well as not for the country also. And let us move to our next point, that ordinary people also, they don't know what is good for them. That is also one of the demerits of democracy. कि आम लोगों को भी इतने वो परेशान रहते हैं, the common people, they are too much busy that they really don't have time to think what is really good for them. And they do not decide, they could not decide anything. Before they decide, the decisions are made. उनके कुछ decide करने से पहले ही decision ले लिया जाता है. Because those elected leaders, they do not come to them to ask or to consult or to discuss with the people of that particular area. So the decisions are made those people who have been elected by these people. But the real thing what should be there, that those elected leaders should consult the people of that particular area where he has been appointed, so that he can know about the people and know about their demand. But in a democratic type of country like India also, everyone is not having much time to decide or to take participate. So that is also one of the demerits of democracy, that people really don't know about them also, and they do not decide anything because everything is decided by the elected leaders over here. That is, we have to go through about the arguments which is in favor of democracy, that is merits of democracy. So let us enjoy the merits of democracy as we have discussed a lot about the demerits. So one of the merit of democracy is that it is better than any form of government because it responds to the needs of the people. People used to ask the government or the local leader of that particular area. They used to write letters to them. They can meet them in their offices also. They can visit them in their residence also. So they will just give out the or inform the people, inform the leader about the about their needs. And in this type of government, the leader is forced, or you can say, have to take decisions and have to respond to the needs of the people. So people over here in a democratic type of government, they can raise their voice, they can protest, and they can ask the government to do a particular work. But in a dictator type of government, dictatorship, where is there is no scope for any type of this protesting. So the people cannot ask the government to do anything for them. So in a democratic type of government, people can ask the government, can force them also to do their work. So that is one of the merits of democracy, which is that it the democratic type of government have to respond to the need of the people. The second one that I like the most, that democratic type of government is more accountable form of government. Accountable means jawabdehi. Yani, the government will have to answer to the people. If the citizen of the country is asking for any type of information regarding the accounts or regarding the uses of the finance of the government of the country, then they will have to give total expenses and income details to the citizen of the country. Because they are accountable in a democratic type of government, they will have to give record or details of every paisa and every amount of money. They will have to give answer to the people. They will have to present that particular sheet that will provide information to the people that where they have used the money that they have collected from the people in the form of taxes and other details also. So democratic is one of the government where it is more accountable than any other form of government. The next point which is going in favor of democracy is that it improves the quality of decision making. Yes, I agree with this point also, because if a lot of people will be consulted, so different views and expression of the people and different ideas will come together, and the best idea will be chosen, and that will be a very good, that will improve the quality of decision making, and that might be the best thing for the people of the country, for the citizen of the country. So if you are consulting people and getting different ideas and choosing the best one, then it really improves the quality of decision. But what we have to do, my students over here, that those particular consultation and decision making should be quick also. Otherwise, it will lead to demerits of democracy. So that is good also, that if you are consulting people and choosing the best option. Again, democracy provides a method to deal with the differences and conflicts. Yes, in a democratic type of government, we have the method that we can consult the people in time of differences and conflicts. यानी आपस में कुछ भेदभाव होता है तो हम लोग आपस में बैठ के बातचीत करके ही उसको सॉल्व कर सकते हैं, है ना? By mutual understanding we can solve the issues. So it provides, because in a democratic type of government people are used to that they have to discuss about the differences and conflicts. क्योंकि लोग जो है इसके आदि रहते हैं कि वो discussion करते हैं हमेशा, तो क्यों ना हम लोग जो है conflict और differences के time में भी क्या करें, हम लोग बैठ के बात कर सकते हैं, discuss कर सकते हैं, and we can resolve all the type of issues and conflicts. So democracy provides that particular platform. Democracy ये platform provide करता है जहाँ पर हम लोग discuss कर सकते हैं. So that is also one of the point which is going in favor of democracy. And that is the most important and the most liked by me also, that it enhances the dignity of citizens. Because in a democratic type of government, everyone is equal. Even the richest person and even the poorest person, you know, all, both of them are having the same type of rights, right of freedom, right of equality, right to live, right to expression, you know. So the same type of right have been given to the richest one as well as the poorest one also. So the dignity of the citizens are equal in a democratic type of government. We might be knowing about the dignity, yani ke ek insaan ka izzat, you know, uske jo hote hain, dignity. So the dignity, or the, you can say the respect of all the citizens are equal in a democratic type of government. No one is more respectable and no one is less respectable in a democratic type of government. So it gives really equal opportunity also to all the citizens to participate in the affairs of the government also. So that is very, very good and important, and that is really the most important one and merits of democracy. That it give equal rights and equal opportunity to each. And the last one is what? Democracy is better than any other form of government because it allows to correct its own mistakes. यहाँ पर chances है that you can reverse the decision, you can modify the decision, or you can just correct your own mistake also in a democratic type of government. But in other form of government, such as monarchy, such as dictatorship type of government, whatever the things have been announced or declared by the monarch or the dictator has to be followed by the citizen of that particular country. But in a democratic type of country, we can ask the government to take back a decision or reverse the decision or just modify the decision to make the things correct also. So that is only the option, and this type of option is only available in a democratic type of government, my dear student. So I am also in favor of this particular point also. So all are the points over here which are going in favor of democracy. And that is good that we are living in a democratic type of government also. So this is the last topic of the chapter. But so broader meaning of democracy, or the conclusion of the chapter, we are going to conclude one, that in a democratic country, all the people do not rule. That is one of the most important thing over here, that people are not ruling. The people are just electing their representatives and they are taking decisions on their behalf. So we must conclude and keep it in our mind that all the people in a democratic government do not rule, but they participate. A majority is allowed to take decisions on behalf of all the people. So you can see a majority of people is there, and they are allowed to take decisions on those people who used to elect them. Even the majority does not rule directly also. So the majority of the government, whoever has won the election, even they do not rule directly, because they have to consult the people or the MLAs or the MP of the particular state or the country to take a particular decisions also. So they do not rule directly even then, after winning the election also, in a majority. And the next one, that is the broader meaning of democracy, that majority of the people rule through their elected representative in a democratic type of government. In this type of government, we used to elect our representative, and those representative take decisions or rule the country or just run the country. Last one, democratic citizen involves consultation. it needs consultation in this particular democratic type of government. Whenever you have to make a decision, you will have to consult. And you will have to take the consent, yani approval. And you will have to take the approval of the people who are going to be affected by that decision. And if you have a decision in public ke khilaf, in ke favor mein lene ja rahe hain, to wo affected honge na, whether they are affected positively or negatively. So it is the need of the time that they have to be consulted, because they are going to be affected with that particular decision. So if they will be consulted before taking the decisions, then the right decision will be able to be made. You know? Right decision will be taken if they are consulted. And the next one, democracy is also a principle that can be applied to any sphere of life. है ना, छोटे-छोटे मामले में भी आप जो डेमोक्रेसी को फॉर्म को यूज कर सकते हैं. सपोज आपके घर में ही कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स आ गए हैं, तो यू ऑल पीपल कैन सिट टुगेदर एंड टेक डिसीजंस. सो इट कैन बी अप्लाइड टू एनी स्फीयर ऑफ लाइफ. एंड द मोस्ट कॉमन फॉर्म ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इन टुडे वर्ल्ड इज दैट पीपल रूल, दैट वर्ल्ड इज रूल थ्रू पीपल इलेक्टेड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव. मोस्ट कॉमन, हर जहां पर भी डेमोक्रेटिक टाइप ऑफ गवर्नमेंट है, एवरीवेयर मोस्ट कॉमन यही है कि the people used to elect their representative and those representative take decision. So that is the most common form of democracy in the world, that rule through people's elected representative. Log jisko elect karte hain as a representative, wahi log rule karte hain. That is the thing, you know, in the most form of the government. So my last question is from you all: is it necessary that the majority of the people ruled be ruled through the elected representative? Kya ye zaruri hai ki majority of people ko rule karna hi chahiye elected representative ke dwara? That is the question. So I would like to comment in the class tomorrow, and you can comment in the YouTube channel also. There is a space to comment. So I would request you all to comment about this question, whether it is really necessary to be ruled in a democratic country with the help of the elected representative. That is all in this class, my dear students. Thank you and bye bye.
Hope that you have liked the video, and we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care, stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care.